Good morning. Greetings. I'm very happy to be with you, and I greet you. I greet all my brother bishops and archbishops, particularly His Eminence Cardinal Di Nardo, who is the president of the Bishops' Conference, and the Archbishop of Sydney, Bishop Fisher. He came with a good number of pilgrims. Where are the Australians here? Where are they? What is that? What is that? Archbishop Fisher did not tell me that he had also some strange animals. So I greet you all as representing the His Holiness Pope Francis in this country. I want you to know how pleased I am to be with you in the Capital One Arena, in the nation's capital, on this day of prayer for the legal protection of unborn children, a day on which we especially give thanks to God for the gift of human life by our participation in the March for Life. Speak out for those who cannot speak for themselves, the most vulnerable in our society, the unborn. In September of 2015, during his apostolic journey to the United States of America, Pope Francis met with the members of the General Assembly of the United Nations Organization. And during his address, the Pope commented, "The common home of all men and women must continue to rise on the foundations of a right understanding of universal fraternity and respect for the sacredness of every human life, of every man and woman, the poor, the elderly, children, the infirm, the unborn, the unemployed, the abandoned, those considered disposable because they are only considered as part of a statistic." End of quote. Dear young people, I suppose everybody is young today, isn't it? Dear young people, thank you for the witness of your Catholic faith, both now at Holy Mass, later on in the streets of Washington, and even more importantly, when you have returned home to your families, schools, and neighborhoods. Know that you are making a solid contribution to the renewal of American society. For the future of this vast country lies in the hands of young people like yourselves, who believe that it has been created as one nation under God, and that no human authority has the right to challenge the law of God. At this time, it is my privilege and honor to read for you the message from our Holy Father, prepared for all of you gathered here in the Archdiocese of Washington, as well as for those assembled this morning in the Diocese of Arlington. This is the message. His Holiness Pope Francis sends warm greetings and the assurance of his closeness in prayer to the many thousands of young people from throughout America gathered in this Archdiocese of Washington and in the Diocese of Arlington for the annual March for Life. His Holiness is deeply grateful for this outstanding witness to the right to life of the most innocent and vulnerable members of our human family. Respect for the sacredness of every human life is fundamental to the building of a truly good, just, and free society in which each person is valued and welcomed as a brother or sister. To construct such a culture of life is a challenging task for each generation. For this reason, Pope Francis trusts that Almighty God will strengthen the commitment of all especially the young, to uphold the inviolable dignity of human life and to ensure its protection through adequate legal measures. With these sentiments, the Holy Father gladly imparts to all who take part in the March for Life and to all who support them by their prayers and sacrifices his apostolic blessing as a pledge of strength and joy in the world. This is the end of the message from Pope Francis. Thank you.